to add to Idrish's point, he's 100% correct. So we all need to recall 5 years back how string inverters came to the market. So back in a time when 100 kilowatt was a central inverter, that is, I'm talking about 2012-13, string inverters were pushed into the market, you know, talking about the redundancy and the number of MPPTs that you know are existing in the system. So with the increasing capacity of inverters, we're losing that beauty. The beauty of a string inverter was redundancy. And with the size that is increasing, the block size increasing, you have 100, you have 125, you have 175. So we are losing that beauty. So the main advantage of a string inverter that was available to us is now gone. And yes, on the other hand, you do have reducing cost, this thing, proposal that is there. But at the same time, we should understand that string inverters, the beauty of it was always to give you a distributed kind of a generation system, and redundancy is what it actually valued for. I personally have supplied 5 kilowatt single phase inverters to a 10 megawatt project back in 2013. So that was almost 2000 numbers. So considering that, I think today to consider 5 kilowatt inverters in a larger rooftop, even for 100 kilowatt, it isn't you know viable. So that's how the market has shifted, but we should all remember one thing that, as Idrish rightly pointed out, we have to consider the fact that smaller inverters are definitely a better solution in terms of plant output. Thank you.
I would like to just highlight on the part of the distributed solar and so on in terms of string inverters. Yes, the beauty of those were like to give redundancy to the projects. That was one part. And secondly, talking about the part of adding features like Fronius, well designed in 2012, for the snap inverter technology, has already inbuilt features of smart energy management, which we are not talking right now. So the in future, we have to also see that which inverter technology will be suited for the future, and based on that, you have to select one. So based on this talks about adding features, redundancy and all this, you have to also see that what is the lifetime of the designed inverter. Like for example, we have a 20 years lifetime. So a lot of manufacturers give their own design lifetime, and that you need to see. And then you have to decide which inverters are best for your projects. Thank you.
I personally feel that there is a market for each and every product, whether rooftop of central inverters, rooftop of string inverters, rooftop of micro inverters. But definitely the technology is the key to every thing, and definitely in future also we'll see a lot of technological revolutions in this other industry as well. As my colleagues have also earlier discussed about 1500 DC inverters. And there is definitely, I think the future that is going to drive up is that we will have a lot of requirements that will be coming up in the micro inverter segment also. So, because with every module there is an inverter that is going to get connected. So definitely that is going to drop down the losses and give a lot of added advantages in terms of the efficiency. So just wanted to share some.
No, I think when we talk about rooftop, every rooftop is unique. You cannot have a single SLDM design, multiple roofs or multiple systems with one SLD. You have to make a new or a specific design for a specific rooftop. And there's a choice available. You can have a micro inverter, you can have a string inverter starting from 1 kilowatt going up to 120 kilowatt. You have choice of string level monitoring, you have choice of multiple MPPT, single MPPT. Again, it is the designer who has to choose what suits them. If it is a very large project, definitely they should go with a higher rating, because then it saves them the cost of the BOSM inverters. If they have orientation issues or shading issues, then they should choose smaller sizing. So it's all dependent on the designer and the understanding they have about the system and the roof which they are trying to design. Just to add about micro inverters, I think they are now coming up with the, so it was like a few years back only central inverters were talked about. Now people are more talking about string inverters. I think the future will be micro inverters, where people will definitely go with module level monitoring, forget about string level monitoring which is offered today. And I think most of the manufacturers are now trying to shift from single MPPT to multiple MPPTs. With Huawei, we are offering almost 100, more than 100 MPPTs per megawatt if you are using Huawei inverters. And there's a big benefit when you have this multiple MPPTs, you have higher generation, you get more yields. So that is all proven and available with all the say projects which have been done in India also. And I think for the smaller systems, I think micro inverter would be the go ahead, because when we are talking about a push for rooftop, and when also we talk about residential market where only 1 or 2 kilowatt is happening, it makes sense for going with the module level monitoring, and that will always help them, because the people who are installing, they have the know-how, but the people who are using the system, they don't know about it, they don't know how to clean it, they know how to maintain it. And it is easy to sell a system to a household, but very difficult for them to maintain it for 20-25 years. And there is also a knowledge transfer which has to be done for them to maintain and ensure that the system is performing, and there is no bad image of solar system because of some other issues which they don't know. And then they say, okay, to the neighbor that I have installed a solar system, but it's not working. So it's not worth putting up a solar system on your roof.
Exactly, I'll set a point to what you said. You know, this is not only to do with the residential, but we did a study actually. We have installed our first string inverter in year 2012 with DMRC. So, and Chintu at that point in time had a collaboration with Sun Edison. So, we have approximately 10 megawatts installed in 2012. And then in 2014, of course, a bad case to decide, but nevertheless, I will do it. But in 2014, Sun Edison went bankrupt. So for 2-3 years, Chint could not sell in India. So they did not have any presence whatsoever. So now, once they came back in operations, we have almost 10 megawatts. And we, after we came back to operation, we only got 4 calls for O&M. So we went and asked Greenco people, now they own the assets. We asked them, so sir, did you not go to the inverter, or did you not do any kind of maintenance, even preventive for that matter? They said, no, we did the work. Now inverter is not working, so we have one. So the psychology in this solar industry or inverter prevails only when the inverter is down, you go to the hut or go to the inverter, because you go and you make it up. Because till 5 years, our inverters were running without any intervention, without any replacement. So people have to understand, if you want them to run for 25 years, you need to have a tender hand, you need to give a little bit of care. Not when it goes bad, because once it goes bad, so of course you will definitely look at it, and then you will call the inverter guy, okay, come, this has gone bad, this has gone bad, so you need to replace it. So this is a very interesting study which we have done. I'm sure you can also do this analysis at your end. How many of our customers, they actually look at inverter when it is put in carrying condition, not when it's broken down? We are doing analysis because we are doing the MTBF report to understand the critical failure of the component. So I think it's a good forum for us to understand and debate on this and bring out this as a unique selling proposition. You know?
I agree with you. Basically, when the technology of inverter was mainly kitchen technology, and now technology what we have right now, it is a vast difference, because now we are providing remote monitoring or communication protocols, everything is there. So there is an IoT platform by which customer can gather all the information together without any wire connection at single location, which will have diagnostic, which will have monitoring, which will have controlling also, which was not earlier. So ideally, if you ask me, I would debate whether we should, customer should clearly take inverter for a warranty of 25 years. Because ideally, 15, 10 years is the right time. Whether you should, after that you should change your system, basically. So 25 years, something, you know, there is an imaginary figure everybody is carrying in their mind about 25 years of warranty period. It should be 15 years, 10 years, sufficient, is what I feel.
Talking about warranties, it's, I think, because most of the customers are designing the system considering a life of 20 or 25 years, and they know that, okay, module is giving 25 years, so why not all the other components? And then they start asking about this, why you cannot give me 25 years? But it all depends, as you said rightly, that it becomes whether you need that or not. Whether you need a 25 years warranty for an inverter is a question. And I I think hardly any customer is talking about 25 years already. Maybe 10 or 15 years is what mostly people are ready to pay for. Because there are everybody, I think, in the panel will be able to offer you an extended warranty. The standard warranty is available, but if you want to have additional extended warranty, it is available. It just depends on how much you want to pay for that, and there's negotiation happening always on the extended warranty. Coming to the micro inverters, we are talking about now smaller systems where I think maybe on 23rd we all know whether the government is coming or not. There's a lot of debate going on whether the exit polls are giving the right feedback or not, but hopefully the government is coming back and they are pushing for the residential market. So residential market, I think there's a big scope because every roof can be converted into a generating system, and everywhere you can install solar. And India being a country getting 300 sunny days or more than 300 sunny days, it makes sense for having a distributed generation. So do you see any trends moving in for future, maybe next 2 years, 3 years, more growth on the residential part?
See, for the rooftop, the residential part, you have added like micro inverters would be the one of the solution. But first, we need to understand that whoever is designing the system, he or she, they first go and check for the sunny area. So when we look at the clear sunny area, if you can find it out, then you don't your PV systems are not going to be affected with any shadow. Then will that micro inverter solution will be a good solution for that particular plant? Because it's going to be cost you more money, because you're going to add modules and every inverter going to be set behind the module. And if you have many number of connections and an interconnection in a plant, that many numbers of trucks. So in my view, as of now, like in 2019, or if you look at 2 year down the line or 3 year down the line, like right now we are looking at good roofs. We are selecting our roofs and we are setting a plant. Once these good roofs are over and we don't find good space to put solar plant, then the micro inverter is only the solution to put the solar and to get and harness solar power and convert it into this.
One quick point, I think already telling us to wind up, but nevertheless, it's 2 minutes. Good roof, bad roof, it's okay. The problem with India is we have a two-fold problem. One is, of course, we are blessed with a lot of sun. But the moment we get into the regulatory, because having a module on every rooftop, so you have to read about the grid. So you have to regulate power, because you, like in net metering, you see the problems we have. So if we have to really get to microgrid inverters, so you can imagine hundreds and thousands of inverters pumping power at any random location. So more of selling a utility or selling a micro inverter is more to do with the framework. So until the time we don't have a framework, it's going to be difficult. I don't see that coming up soon. But if we address those issues properly, then for sure it's a huge problem.
I would thank all the panelists, and I would like to open the session for questions. So, okay, sir, you can ask the question, and maybe anyone of us from the panel will answer.
Very simple question to Mr. Idris, Javed, and Mr. Khan. See, we are in the era of disruption. Are we prepared with this micro going back to nano inverter? If that is the case, what is your response?
Sir, definitely there are people who are working and trying to bring up even smaller solutions. But considering the module sizes, and we are talking about increase in the module size from earlier it was 250, now going to 400. So it all depends on the other components also. So possibly microinverter is visible, but if there are possibility very high efficiency cells available in future, maybe then we also see some nano inverters coming up where you can have maybe very small systems which you can be used in future. But that is more futuristic. I have not heard about any such development, but maybe anybody who has. So I think it's probably happening, but it's not right now in the public domain.
Technology will be one thing that will be driving this solar segment, because the market is too good. and everybody will find a place for himself. It is not that only one technology will find a place, everybody will find a place for himself. So, but the thing is that the awareness to this thing is very, very, it's not really, there's not a huge awareness to it. But yes, coming forward, I do see such kind of technologies coming up. Even something better than that is also even next.
Yeah, so I was just talking to my colleague here. So
yeah, most of the companies which you showed the presentation, the innovation part you are doing is excellent. I saw some 3-4 presentations. So I have one query for single phase inverter only for small solar projects, not for 3-phase and larger projects. Can inverters be avoided? I know you will laugh at my question, but there is some study going on. I know some people for a single phase, again I am repeating, for smaller rooftop or smaller solar project, can inverters be avoided?
As long as the loads are going to be DC, I think definitely inverters can be avoided, no doubt there. Because otherwise it's just going to be a double work for you. So you're converting it into AC again, and then your switches that are there in your household are on DC again. So you have to convert it to DC for the electronics. So I think it's just around.
Or the modules are producing direct AC. So,
yeah.
So it has to be done through maybe an inverter or a micro inverter or a nano inverter, which comes in the
future. There are very team working which is trying to create low voltage DC motors which are safe to use in a single phase directly from your PV modules, no inverters.
Yeah, that is possible. As you said, it is not DC, DC load, yes. But I don't think that would be mass scale use because you always are using.
It is for single phase small projects.
Yeah. Special applications would be possible. Okay, thank you very much.
Brinder, one question to the panel. How do you see the future of the optimizer integrating with the inverters in India?
Again, it depends on the cost you pay. So if you are ready to pay the cost, definitely optimizers are available. It is available today. It's used in US and Europe, but India, always we talk about cost. You talk about optimizer cost, it is...
Technical point of view, what is your suggestion whether going with the optimizer? You forget the cost right now. Whether it is prudent or it makes sense, because in India we have the roofs which are typically it is a flat, those are big roofs, no shading, nothing is there. So with those kind of typical structures what we are having in India, whether it makes sense to go for a optimizer with inverter?
Yes, you can use micro inverters or optimizers with string inverters, depends on the size you want to build up. But I think if you are using optimizer or micro inverter versus string inverter, I think the improvement in the generation will be 20 to 30%. There are studies done and there are systems which have been done.
So the amount of money which you spend and the amount of generation benefit you are getting, that calculation if you do that, then you will end up that it's better to not to go with optimizer.
But also you can add the module. Because the moment you saw the money, people are going to add, okay, let's do one thing, let's add 2-3% module extra. Why we are paying right now for the inverter itself?
Also, it is easy to control a classroom of 10 students instead of 100 students. So, you can judge it yourself, which is a better option for you.
If the students are good, you can control it. So, it is not a problem of the number, but I think it's more about how you choose it and is it necessary required. But today I think the cost is high, so it is not being pushed, but probably in future when the cost or when the mass scale is happening, then definitely the cost will go down and it will also give you opportunity to use that system for the challenges which you have faced in the world. Okay, thank you very much.
We have all the inverter manufacturers are sitting here on the panel, and we all agree that no matter what technology Solis is offering, Sungrow is offering, Huawei and everywhere, wherever this inverter is being installed, that inverter is not being handled by a right skilled person. EPC, developer, all big names you take, they offshore their work to a subcontractor who don't even know which machine he's handling. And
when the machine has been installed and you see this has been handled by wrongly, and then we start finding that inverters is not performing well. So it's also our responsibility, the EPC company or developer, who should also need to educate their people when they are doing execution part, operation and maintenance, all these things. Please refer the manuals and the instruction being given by a manufacturer. You are putting your money, you are putting everything, you are selecting all the right components, doing all engineering, but the not right execution, not right operation and maintenance, you won't be getting any benefit. So this is just one message which I want to pass on this podium. Like, we all are known in industry, and we know what business we are doing. So it's a very pain for an inverter manufacturer when somebody is coming to and saying that there is a fault in your inverter. But when we do a analysis and find it out that somebody is that not handled the machine in a proper way, and they have not installed the machine in a proper way.
Social trending will come.
Social trending.
No, they are saying in India, customer is king, so you have to follow what they do. But it is better to give them education and try to have some information passed, and they should at least follow that. Otherwise, when we are talking about system reliability and working performance for 20-25 years, definitely it will not be able to come. And then it is easy to blame the manufacturer that you have given me a wrong thing, instead of introspecting and seeing that
whether anything goes wrong, inverter is doing right.
Not always. So I would thank you all for your attention, and I would now close the session. We are, I think, 5 minutes late, so Anand is waiting for me.
Thank you, Pranjali. I request Mr. Arjun Munjal to present a mentor on behalf of the organizer to the panelists on the stage. Thank you very much.